Hi, I'm Dr. Rajdeep. I'm a dermatologist and dermatosurgeon practicing at Charma, a skin, hair and nail clinic attached to Chirag Hospital in JP Nagar, Bangalore. Another common condition which we see in a dermatology clinic is fungal infection. There are various types of funguses and there are various types of fungal infections. The commonest fungal infection which we see in clinics is called as Tinea Corporis or Tinea Cruris. Tinea group of infections are usually caused by fungus called as dermatophytes. Dermatophytes are fungus which can be present on skin, which can be present in soil, or which can be present in the animals or pets which we have around us. So fungus which is normally present on skin doesn't cause that much of inflammation or redness is not there. But the fungus which you may get from pets or animals, that will have more red patches. So this kind of tinea infection is also called as ringworm. So it has many names. So earlier it was thought to be due to worms and it used to leave a round ring-like patch on the body. So in Hindi they say dad, in Kannada they say kajji. So it has so many different names. And if it occurs in the groin area, which is the commonest area where it occurs, it's called as dhobi itch or jock itch, because it's more common in those who are sports people, jocks. Or it is more common in those who are dhobis, washing clothes and all, because they sweat more. And sweat is one of the most common factors which predisposes a patient to fungal infections. Other conditions where moisture is high, like if your clothes are not washed properly, or if you are getting wet in the rain, or if you are getting wet in a river or lake or swimming pool. So these kind of things can also predispose you to fungal infections. Also, fungal infections can spread to your family members. So other people can get it from your towels, clothes, etc. Other more rarer types of fungal infection, there is another one called Tinea versicolor, that is caused by a different type of fungus called malassezia, that leaves small round patches which is usually not itchy, and it has very thin flakes and usually easy to cure. Then other fungal infections affect the nail, that is called onycomycosis. You might have seen in older people, their nails will be damaged and broken. So this is a fungal infection of the nail. In children, we see more common fungal infections of the hair. So fungal infection of hair is called as Tinea capitis. It's usually caused where a lot of oil is applied to the hair and caps are applied to the hair, and hair washing is not done frequently. So fungal infections require a course of antifungal medications, topical antifungals, and they need to be monitored by the dermatologist regularly, because if it is treated inadequately, so partial treatment will lead to relapse. So we see nowadays that many of the fungal infections are quite resistant to antifungals and patients don't take the course completely. Earlier we used to give antifungal for 1 or 2 weeks and patient used to get cured. Now we need to give the same antifungals for 2-3 months or sometimes even up to 6 months for curing the patient. Also we have different newer antifungals which are more effective. And in case the patient is resistant to normal antifungal treatment, we start them on these new antifungals. The most important factor for making fungal infection persist or spread is moisture. So make sure that your clothes are dry completely, if possible in sunlight. If there's no sunlight, iron your clothes before you wear it. And make sure you don't wear clothes which you're sweated in a lot again and again. So that can also increase fungal infections. And make sure that if one member of the family has fungal infection, their clothes, towels, bed sheets, etc. are washed separately and preferably washed in water which is more than 60 degrees Celsius. So hot water. So these are some of the things which you can do at home to reduce the incidence of fungal infections.